Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to answer your Datamart questions. Let's go. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, you've got questions. I'm going to try and give you some answers here. Please note that these answers are my opinions. You need to weigh these against what you're seeing on your end and what your business requirements are. We've been getting questions on the videos that we put out, as well as in our live streams and what we're hearing from customers as well. So I wanted to kind of answer some of the more common questions I've been hearing. Again, if you're not familiar with Datamarts, you don't even know what I'm talking about, go check out this video, Exploring Datamarts, talking about the new capability that was announced at Build 2022. And also, go check out this video, which looks at data flows versus data marts. And with that, let's get into the questions. First question, this is a big question. Is there still a place for data flows? I'll point you back to the video I did on data flows versus data marts. And the answer there is yes. The thing you need to remember is there are a lot of different tools that are available to you now from a Power BI perspective. So data flows, data marts, data sets, you need to empower yourself with understanding the pros and cons or the benefits and considerations for each one of those and pick the right tool for what you're trying to accomplish. And there are scenarios where data flows is the better option compared to data marts. So definitely go check out that video I did specifically on that point. Question number two, can I control what's refreshed inside of a data mart? You know, if I've got a bunch of tables in there, can I just refresh one table versus the whole thing? And the answer today is no. If you're refreshing the data mart, you've got to refresh the whole data mart. You're not going to be able to just go refresh an individual table like you can with a data set and the XMLA endpoint. You can take advantage of incremental refresh. So for larger fact tables, that will help to make it faster. So you're not refreshing everything, but in general, you don't have the selectability today. Maybe sometime in the future, those aspects will come as it gets closer to general availability and or beyond. Another interesting question was, does this mean I just don't need to create data sets anymore? And the answer there is maybe. It depends. The thing to understand here, going back to the first question of, there are different tools at your disposal and what you want to do. So Datamarts itself is not going to be the answer to everything. So there may be scenarios where a fully fleshed out data set with all the full capabilities is available to you, and that's the option that you want to go do for enterprise data modeling. Datamarts does come with an automatic data set that's available, and that will provide you a good starting point, and it may be all you need to do the reports that you want to accomplish. You can add measures inside of the Datamart itself and the automated data set that gets generated as part of it. It doesn't have all the functionality that you're going to have from an actual full-flown data set or, you know, what you can do inside a Power BI desktop today. So the answer to this question is probably not. It depends on your situation, right? All right, is Power Query faster in Datamarts than in other areas like data flow or a data set? And also a secondary piece of this question is, do I still need to care about query folding as part of Power Query? The answer to this is, I don't know. Like, you've got to look at this. Sorry, I'm not giving you a definitive answer, but if you're doing the same transformations in data flows, data marts, and data sets, I would expect them to be pretty much the same. Like, I don't know why one would be faster versus the other. So that's a general standpoint. When it comes to query folding, absolutely, you need to pay attention to that. I don't care what you're doing with Power Query, you want to take advantage of query folding, regardless of where it is. If you're not and something breaks, I would see that performance degradation as a result of not query folding across the board. I'd see it in a data set, I'd see it in a data mart, I'd see it in a data flow. So it's going to impact you in every area if you're not paying attention to it. But always test and verify. Try it in Power BI Desktop. Compare it to what you're seeing in Datamarts. See what your behavior is based on what you're doing with your transformations and what the data sources are. All right, this last question that we got is, I think, a really important one. Came up in our live stream, and the question was, should I migrate an existing working data set over to a Datamart? And my answer there is, why would you? If you're looking at this from a new development, so I'm just creating a new report or a new operation, that's where I would look at, maybe I want to use a Datamart versus a data set and weigh those options and figure out which one to go after. If you already have an existing working data set, it doesn't make sense to me why I would spend the time and the effort to recreate everything into a data mart, because then I also have to refactor my reports and everything that's involved in that. I'm not lazy, I'm efficient. And just for the sake of moving it over a data mart because it's the new shiny, to me, that's not efficient. Unless there's a problem with it and maybe data marts help solve that problem, I would not migrate it. Absolutely not. All right, hopefully those answers helped you. Maybe you've got other questions. Let me know what those are down in the comments below and we'll try and get to them. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.